The best supply chains are the ones you don't see. Customers never have to think about them. They just walk into your store or go online, and the products they want to buy are available immediately. But if you're not ready when demand spikes, or supplies get delayed, your customers are left waiting. You lose sales revenue, and partners who rely on you lose trust. Managing these disruptions is a big problem for companies that rely on aging, customized business applications that make it difficult to change course. Oracle provides a full suite of supply chain and manufacturing applications that run in the cloud. That includes everything you need to bring new products to market and effectively manage procurement, manufacturing, inventory, and logistics. When you see big changes to demand or the flow of goods, Oracle Supply Chain Planning can help you react quickly to balance supply and demand. If there's a disruption with a key supplier, Oracle Procurement helps you identify trusted sources of supply to keep your factories running at full capacity. And Oracle Transportation and Global Trade Management help you fulfill orders perfectly, whether it's by land, sea, or air, and enable you to comply with fast-changing global trade regulations. By leveraging sensory data, machine learning, and blockchain, you can monitor the flow of goods and their condition, connect fleets, anticipate machine repairs, and monitor workplace safety. And you can focus on running your supply chain since all the updates are managed for you to help you continuously adapt and innovate. See how Oracle Supply Chain and Manufacturing can help you improve resilience and keep customers happy beyond your next move.
Welcome to the Oracle Cloud Supply Chain Virtual Summit. I'm Glenn Senninger, Group Vice President for Supply Chain Applications at Oracle North America.
And I am Marcel Kars, Head of Supply Chain and Manufacturing Sales, Oracle Western Europe.
I hope you enjoyed our opening video. As you can see, there are many moving parts to the supply chain. There's complexities that you're dealing with as customers. We're excited about today's program and what you're about to see. The format includes a wide array of supply chain topics presented by a range of guest speakers, each with a unique perspective and story to tell. They include Deloitte, Bissell, MTN, Alcar, Transworld, and of course, Oracle. Today, we'll explore solutions that support insight and collaboration through conversations, videos, and demonstrations. And I'm really excited about today's event. Marcel, it's a pretty strong lineup, wouldn't you agree?
Yes, indeed, Glenn. And they span the globe and many different industries too. Everything from wheels to floor care, and we'll talk about manufacturing and logistics. There is really something for everyone. I like the fact that we get to hear a perspective from North America, Europe, the Middle East, and Asia Pacific. Many different environments, to be sure, but we all face common supply chain and manufacturing challenges. Today's 1 hour virtual summit consists of all those guest speakers. We also receive questions from you, our audience, and have selected some of them to address as we go through the program. Glenn, myself, and our colleague, Michael Lim, will introduce customers that are based in our regions and will refer to questions that are addressed in each segment. I hope you enjoy the show. Let's get started. So, Glenn, what do you mean by insight and collaboration?
Well, Marcel, insight and collaboration consists of three major components. First is to drive better, faster decision-making with metrics and insights, and to incorporate that with machine learning, predictive analytics, and recommendations based on a unified machine, product, customer, and operational data model. Second is to connect, accelerate, and unite planning across all functions in the supply chain and move toward a continuous planning model. And third, help customers gain a multi-tier visibility in their supply chain with the ability to track and trace repairs, replacements, deliveries with suppliers.
And why is it important?
Well, it's a good question, because by implementing these core concepts as a customer, you can leverage advanced technologies that are built into the solution and deliver those solutions through a continuous process of improvement in your planning model. You'll gain transparency across the supply chain and the insights you need to help you make faster, better, and more concise decisions.
So you mean advanced technologies like AI, machine learning, IoT, blockchain, Glenn?
That's a good question. And the answer to that is yes. But even more important is how everything needs to work together. It has to be integrated. So at Oracle, we make sure that these new technologies are embedded into the supply chain solution and then across all of our SaaS applications. Ultimately, we're looking to gain more visibility, better collaboration, and when we have those come together, we gain new insights and are able to make critical decisions with the right data at the right time for our customers. Sounds pretty easy, right?
Yes. It will be very interesting to hear all the different perspectives and stories. But why now? Is it because of the pandemic?
Well, you know, Marcel, that's part of it. But the ongoing quest for supply chain expertise and excellence has been much more than just responding to the current situation. We've been evolving and improving for years at Oracle. It's just that in a situation like a global pandemic or a trade war or some other unforeseen event, our weaknesses are exposed. I'll let our guest speakers share more about why now, more than ever. These capabilities are so important to supply chains. It's always inspiring to hear new ways of doing things. But one thing's for sure, the time is now, and it's more important than ever because lives depend on it.
Wow, yeah. Do you have any examples?
Sure, Marcel. We have a large telecommunications customer that is using Oracle Supply Chain and manufacturing, including intelligent track and trace. They're employing this technology to gain more insights and to help drive performance with better collaboration across their entire network of supply chain members. They're tracking the set-top boxes for satellite TV, and in order to do this, they need visibility to detect issues and trace it right down to the serial number across the supply chain. So with that, let's take a deeper look.
When customers turn on their set-top box, it just works, which makes it easy to forget the complex technology behind it. How much went into making it and delivering it? It's made from parts sourced from all over the world and uses smart manufacturing with IoT connectivity and big data analytics to monitor environmental factors and predict, detect, and fix production issues in real time. Then it's shipped to the warehouse for receiving and inventory control, where its precise location with its unique ID is tracked. So when an order is placed, we know exactly what to look for and where it is, so we can grab it and deliver it. When it's time for an upgrade, we do it all in reverse, making decisions about whether to recycle its parts or refurbish it for another customer. And if there's ever an issue, its serial number lets us trace the problem all the way back through the system to resolve it. It's all made possible by using Oracle Intelligent Track and Trace with built-in integrations with warehouse and transportation management systems and IoT fleet monitoring. We can help to connect partners, trace every step, and identify exceptions right down to the serial number, across vendors, business units, and continents, securely and safely, so that everything works together for the ultimate goal, delivering joy. Oracle, creating global simplicity.
Great video. There's so many complexities, but this story makes it all seem so simple. How about if we ask one of our consulting partners? In fact, today's global virtual program is made possible with the support of our sponsor, Deloitte. Thank you, Deloitte, for being such a great partner with Oracle. In fact, we share many customers, and our collaboration is a true statement to collaboration, one of the themes for today's topic. Our first speaker is Jeff Croxon, principal at Deloitte. Jeff leads the Oracle Supply Chain and Manufacturing Cloud practice for Deloitte US. He works at the intersection of data, information, and the physical production and distribution of manufactured goods. In this role, Jeff works with clients to unlock the transformative benefits of a digital supply chain and is helping to shape the next generation of Oracle supply chain and manufacturing cloud solutions. I can't think of a better way to kick off this program than by talking about whether your supply chain is an always-on strategic differentiator.
Hi, everybody. My name is Jeff Croxon. I'm a partner at Deloitte, and I lead our Oracle Supply Chain Cloud practice. Happy to be here today chatting with you all at this virtual summit. What we're going to cover today is what we're seeing in the marketplace around resilient supply chains. And then we're also going to spend some time talking about several case studies where we can talk about how a lot of our current clients are improving their supply chain collaboration, insights, and visibility. So the first topic that I'd like to cover is five major characteristics of resilient supply chains. We see the whole multi-sourcing aspect where you've got supply chains that have backup suppliers, risk mitigation approaches, so that if there is disruption in your supply chain, you have alternate sourcing methods to source raw materials and components and products from. The second aspect was all around supply chain planning. And how can you really digitize that whole aspect? The third item is really all about network diversification. And this is not just diversifying the supplier base, but really diversifying the supplier base and looking at it from a lens of geography, region. The other aspect here is really around ecosystem partnerships. So a lot of the resilient supply chains and what we call leading practice organizations, building stronger partnerships with not just their supplier base, but also their network of freight carriers, 3PLs, subcontract or contract manufacturers, really strengthening those relationships and building, you know, a strong ecosystem so that organizations can really weather any kind of storms that may come up in or any disruptions to their global supply chain base. And last but not least is all about building inventory and capacity buffers. I'd like to go ahead and pivot and talk about a few different case studies around organizations and how they've improved their supply chain visibility, insight, and ability to make, you know, more well-informed decisions in terms of their supply and demand planning. So the first client that I'd like to talk about is a company called Titan International. Titan International is a multi-billion-dollar global organization that manufactures tires and wheels and undercarriages for the off-highway automotive market. What Titan was looking to do was consolidate the systems, develop a common set of processes, and really lay a foundation for future growth. What this solution did was enable Titan to have much better visibility into their production line. Whereas before Oracle, they had to rely on data that was 24 to 48 hours old. Titan is now able to record production real time with photo-enabled sensors. And this allows the shipping department to have immediate visibility into finished products so that they can make more well-informed decisions about what product to put on the truck and when, and exactly when that product's going to be ready to go out the door or onto a trailer. And that is really crucial for a business like Titan when you're supporting, you know, a very large OEM automotive customer that has a very automated assembly line. So it's critical to have that real-time visibility and integration between supply chain, as well as manufacturing, operations, shop floor, and the shipping department. Real-time data allows for real-time reporting and information so that they can react to supply chain changes much faster. And really what this is gonna do is give them a global set of processes and solutions that they can deploy, you know, throughout the rest of their operations throughout the world. I'd like to go ahead and pivot to another case study. Again, this is all about supply chain visibility. And this particular case study is actually about a leading fast casual food chain. So this is an organization that has about, you know, 2,600 stores throughout the US and Canada, and then about 20 distribution centers that support these retail operations. And so really what this company was looking to do is improve their supply and demand planning capabilities, as well as their S&OP operations, and really create an integrated business plan. They implemented Oracle Supply Chain Cloud solutions, and this has enabled them to produce a much better forecast, have a lot more visibility, and this has also allowed them to institute a whole suite of analytics so that they can measure the accuracy of the forecast, make better, well-informed decisions, And then another aspect of the impact here is really around supply chain collaboration. So this solution has also enabled this particular client to work more closely with their suppliers, not just the 3PLs that operate the distribution centers, but also their suppliers of the actual food ingredients, whether it be the protein or the vegetables. So they can share this much improved and more accurate forecast information with all of their suppliers so that their suppliers can be in a better prepared to react to any supply chain decisions that they make. I'd like to turn to this third case study, which is one of our clients, which is Bissell, the floor care product manufacturing company. Bissell, over the past few years, has embarked on a series of acquisitions along with a tremendous growth in the organization. And they were also faced with or impacted by a lot of the trade and tariff challenges. What they needed was a solution that would help them respond to these trade and tariff challenges, support the growth of the company, and really provide a platform to integrate a lot of the recent acquisitions with the core operations. They were able to implement a standard set of processes in the supply chain. And so really what this has allowed them to do is perform supply and demand operations around the clock. They also are taking advantage of the full suite of analytics and KPIs and dashboards that come with the application so that they can measure the accuracy of their forecasts. This has also allowed them to share forecast information and demand data with a lot of their contract manufacturers. And another benefit of the solution is that they can better respond to, changes in global trade and tariff challenges. And again, all of this is enabled by Oracle Supply Chain Planning Cloud, along with the Product Hub Cloud, all integrated to their existing on-prem e-business suite solution. So these are the three case studies that I wanted to share. And again, these are all based on Deloitte's experience working with our clients to help them improve their supply chain insight, collaboration, and visibility. Thanks, everybody, for allowing us to share some of our insights and stories. And have a great rest of your day and enjoy the rest of the summit. Thanks.
Depending on your business, demand may surge or be reduced based on factors beyond your control. However, there are ways to be more predictive and to have insights with the right data so you can adequately plan and prepare for surges in demand. Our next guest has some interesting stories to share about how they've experienced a surge in demand for their floor care and cleaning business, even during the current business climate. They'll also discuss how they are shifting operations to a new location to mitigate tariff increases. The company I'm referring to, of course, is Bissell. We have two speakers, Joe Butts and Chris Jackman. Bissell is a client of Deloitte's, and Jeff Croxon has come in today and is posing some questions to the Bissell team about how their business and their international endeavors are coming together.
Hi, everybody. My name is Jeff Croxon. I'm a principal with Deloitte, and I lead our global Oracle supply chain practice. Today, we have a few folks from one of our clients, Bissell, which is a name a lot of you are probably familiar with. They're going to spend a little bit of time here kind of talking about their digital transformation story and their journey to the cloud. With that, let me go ahead and turn it over to Joe and Chris to introduce themselves. Chris, do you want to go first?
My name is Chris Jackman. I'm an associate manager of forecasting at Bissell.
And Joe, do you want to introduce yourself now?
Yeah, my name is Joe Butts. I'm an associate director here at Bissell, overseeing the Oracle applications and the development team here at Bissell.
Well, thanks to both of you for being on. We really appreciate it. Can you go ahead and describe what your company does and what sets you apart from your competitors?
Yeah, Bissell's been around for about 144 years. We're a family-owned company here in West Michigan. We specialize in floor cleaning products in every category. Our emphasis is really in the pet business side of the thing. We try to differentiate ourselves by, we have things like the Bissell Pet Foundation, which Kathy Bissell started in 2011, that really emphasizes pet adoption. And we've integrated that into our product line as well. That's really set us apart from some of our competitors. As we've grown over the last several years, we've noticed that we just didn't have the capabilities to keep up with the information that we needed to have. So we came from Demantra on-prem to go to Oracle Cloud. That's really been helpful for us from a global standpoint. The US market basically has been saturated and we've grown as much as we possibly could in the US. So we really wanted to emphasize our outside of the US business, and integrating different parts of the world has been really key to our integration of the new Oracle product. planning for us has really changed over the last 10 to 20 years. Because we're sourcing a lot of our products overseas, the supply planning module has just been really important for us because we've had to have multiple suppliers be able to fill all of our demand that allow us to show us our demand and supply.
I know that global trade has affected your business. What moves are you making to respond to that increased trade tariffs and the other global impacts as of late?
So over the last year, we've really made a strong effort to expand our supply base outside of China. And doing that has brought on many different suppliers, different sizes, different capabilities, different technical aspects that they have, both digitally and just even their production ability. And being able to see both demand and supply has been really critical for us over the last year. The global pandemic has affected everybody differently. It's affected our business for sure. It took us probably a good 4 to 8 weeks for us to figure out that we were one of the fortunate ones to be in an industry that's really valuable right now and essential. As more families are staying home, their houses have become dirtier, or that they've at least noticed so. So they've needed more cleaning products over the last 6 months as we've been all going through this together. So we went from a nervous state of, are we going to be able to maintain our sales, to quickly trying to figure out how many more units we were going to be selling and how quickly we could bring those in to be able to make that happen.
I have one additional question for you, Chris. What are some of those key capabilities above and beyond what you had with the on-prem applications that are really the most valuable to Bissell at this point?
We really struggled with having independent businesses across the world not being able to communicate with each other very well because of time zone issues and length of overnight job issues. We were really limiting our international businesses and what they could forecast and what they could plan. By going to cloud, we were able to shorten some of those times and allow more global analysis and forecasting. And which is a valuable input to us here in West Michigan. What we can see in Australia is really valuable, and we need to make sure they get their data. And as we've grown, we've had to expand our distribution outlets, and they really need to know what's on the horizon, and we're able to do that a whole lot better in cloud.
Okay. Well, thanks a lot, Chris. I'd like to pivot now and shift some of the questions over to Joe from an IT standpoint. I know that Bissell has been a longtime user of Oracle's on-prem applications, but specifically about the cloud, what are some of the insights that are most important to you that Bissell's really gained from an IT perspective?
Visibility is critical. That, along with the demands of having inventory, just because of the demands for our product, the visibility is key. The cloud has enabled us to make it a singular process. And then if you have a singular process on your, on your forecasting and the supply model, the collaboration then becomes easier, because you're all using the same process to achieve the same goals. Our business has sustained, significant growth through this pandemic. I always have a mantra that when business is good, demands on IT are also going to be high. In our Oracle space at Bissell, we haven't implemented, EBS and then stopped. We continue to grow. We continue to look for Oracle to provide us, with solutions to as our business grows and as our business changes.
I do have one additional question. What are some of the key lessons learned around kind of user adoption, training, communications that you could share with the rest of the audience?
I think it's important to communicate that where you are on your journey to the users and to the stakeholders. And we're fortunate at Bissell. We had great executive sponsorship.
Was it true that Bissell's looking at incorporating some IoT technology into the actual, robotic cleaning devices and some of the other home care products?
We do have some connected products out there today where we can, gather, information from the devices in terms of the cleaning effectiveness, how often it's done, this sort of thing. We are continuing to grow that practice.
Joe and Chris, thank you very much for participating in our panel today. We really appreciate you sharing a lot of the Bissell journey here. And again, we at Deloitte are very much looking forward to partnering with Bissell on as you continue your transformation journey. So very much appreciate it. Thank you.
We've heard firsthand from some supply chain experts on how they've approached challenges in running their supply chains. Let's take a moment to hear from their partner, Oracle. Our next guest is John Chorley, Group Vice President of Supply Chain and Manufacturing at Oracle. John is a veteran in supply chain and technology and will share with you Oracle's approach to drive performance for more insight and collaboration across your organizations. He'll also share an example of Oracle production and a demonstration of a SaaS application with embedded blockchain and more.
Hello, my name is John Chorley, and thank you for joining this session on driving supply chain performance with insight and collaboration. I don't think even Lisa Shalette of Morgan Stanley quite appreciated the depth and duration of the impact of COVID-19 when she wrote this in April. However, this crisis had made clear the role of supply chains and the central importance of insight and collaboration across those supply chains in developing a true, resilient, and recurring revenue stream. However, the bigger picture is that COVID-19 has underlined and accelerated trends that were already underway. Global pressures were changing, with marginal cost savings often not worth the exposure of complete single sourcing. In an e-commerce services or product as service world, customer proximity and speed is now more important than initial cost. Sustainability in corporate branding, business models, and in maintaining a license to operate is a growing factor, as is competition, as barriers to entry continue to fall, often driven by disruptive technologies, which are both a cause of and a potential solution for many of these challenges. So as we respond to COVID-19 impacts, how can we navigate from tactical responses towards strategic initiatives with improved insight and collaboration that will enable you to compete, thrive, and grow in the new normal? There is a progression in how we respond to any crisis, such as COVID-19. The first is to react and respond, making the best use of tools and products that you have, adapting them as best as possible to new ways of doing business. In phase two, you can start to develop what you need for the new normal and to begin to shift resources to future systems, products, and services. The third phase is to start this transition to newer and differentiated products. Here is where having a flexible, constantly evolving information platform is critical. The final phase is to accelerate into growth by leveraging your capabilities in new and evolving markets. But of course, it doesn't stop there. The cycle is continuous. The key point is that these initiatives have different timelines. The more structural the change, the longer it takes. If you wait to exit one phase before working on the next, it will simply be too late. So if you want to become a resilient business, you have to be investing now, not just to respond to this crisis, but to enable you to respond to any crisis. The four connected aspects required for any successful supply chain initiative are visibility, insight, planning, and action. Each of these must flow one to the other in a holistic, connected digital thread. Visibility: collect disparate information from a variety of sources across the supply chain. Insight, the ability to segment and analyze that data so as to extract meaningful information. Planning, the ability to translate these insights into operationally achievable plans across different timescales. And action, the ability to translate these plans automatically into action. Oracle is a good example of how to be more informed and context aware. We have managed a multi-billion dollar enterprise and supply chain producing servers for over a decade. We work with manufacturing partners on three continents and ship products to well over 200 countries. Let's take a look at how this is done with this short video.
Hi, my name is Giovanni Shortek and I lead business transformation for Oracle's hardware supply chain. Oracle has had a noteworthy supply chain since the acquisition of Sun Microsystems in 2010. The core of what we do is assembly and test of enterprise computing technology, both for on-premise deployment and for our own cloud data centers. We work with four main EMS partners today. They are specialized, assigned by technology, and they're located across the world. China, Thailand, Mexico, and the US. Historically, we have had a hands-off, almost turnkey relationship with them. But the cloud is driving a need for stronger integration and closer collaboration. So we are investing in visibility and co-planning. And our supply chain truly has a global reach. We deliver into 136 countries, I think was the last count. We have four key contract manufacturers and 50 plus suppliers that we synchronize our forecast with on a weekly basis. We do that for one tier so far, but are investing in multi-tier visibility and collaboration through supply chain collaboration. We do have the option to allocate or move products and geographic demand as well. The key performance indicator for planning in this supply chain has historically been planning accuracy. We have started to focus on planning responsiveness, driving much shorter cycle times and react to new insights and changes in plans from our sales partners. The achievement that I am most proud of with regards to cloud supply chain planning is that we have been able to connect forecasting and execution without batch synchronization, resulting in the removal of delays and disconnects. The result is speed. We can now run a full end-to-end cycle, and that is from a demand forecast change through MRP to a supply commit back from our supply partners in a single week. And this used to take 3 weeks or more in our old architecture. And if we want to make incremental changes, we can even do that in 24 hours. So that is on the tactical side. On a more strategical level, we have built a foundation for ongoing innovation with our quarterly updates. Adjusting to new requirements or adapting new features is a structured routine exercise now and almost part of our new DNA.
To meet these new challenges, you need a broad, complete, and innovative supply chain platform. And that platform is the Oracle Supply Chain Management Cloud. Designed and built for the cloud, a true SaaS solution that supports complex business flows across all aspects of the supply chain and which enables you to drive Industry 4.0 initiatives towards resilient, circular, sustainable business models. We've made it very easy to ingest data from multiple sources and to drive integrated cross-functional business processes due to the integrated nature of the Oracle Supply Chain Cloud. To give just one example, supporting e-commerce initiatives by seamlessly combining the capabilities of transportation, warehouse management, and order management. These out-of-the-box integrated flows can be augmented with integration cloud support using Oracle Integration Cloud, so that you can connect other systems and applications outside of Oracle. All these business processes can be further enhanced by IoT applications, which extend the insight and connectivity into the physical world, and link this into the digital thread of supply chain processes. This is in each of these domains: manufacturing, maintenance, logistics, and HR. We also apply private blockchain capabilities to support supply chains by incorporating it into SaaS applications, Oracle Intelligent Track and Trace, and linking that to Oracle Supply Chain Cloud, making it easy for business users to get up and running faster while realizing multi-tier visibility and establishing greater trust amongst members of the network. To illustrate this, let's take a look at how Oracle Intelligent Track and Trace can help you achieve more visibility with external supply chain partners.
Hey folks, Nick Pesch here. Today we're going to take a quick look at Oracle Intelligent Track and Trace, specifically our food and beverage use case around brewing beer. We have our founder, F1 Brewer, and then the corresponding trading partners associated with the brewer's logistics network. Now, all of the documents and transactions that take place from those trading partners, as well as F1 Brewers, are collaborated into these different business flows. So as you can see in the top right-hand side here, we have 78 documents associated with this business flow, and they're coming from all sorts of different trading partners and different applications. Now, we pull that critical information out into these process flows. And from here, we can see these flows are made up of one, the name, what the transaction taking place is, the document associated with it, the submitter. And then we also have some built-in logic to include smart contracts, such as identifying and notifying us, in this case, if a purchase order isn't received 3 days after the sales order. Now, diving in a little bit deeper, I wanted to show what one of these events would look like. So here I have a temperature threshold violation that's occurred, which will generate one, an event, and then two, a potential action. So I have a violation that occurred en route. It was greater than 45 degrees. And then I have an email sent to F1 Brewer telling me about that. So drilling into this actual event, the telemetry event took place during the ship product phase of the business flow. But drilling in even further into what we call our chronological trace, here I can see the actual blockchain distributed ledger where all of these different events are being recorded. I've got a date and timestamp on the left-hand side. I can see what corresponding business process flow in the middle here, as well as the trading partner, and then a hyperlink to the document. Taking a look at our different sales orders and purchase orders, once I get down to some of our telemetry events, I can see our transportation event here that has occurred where the brew or the temperature en route reached 49 degrees, thus violating our service provider contract and generating that event and notification. Very powerful tool where all of these transactions are being recorded again on that distributed ledger. They're securely recorded using cryptography and can absolutely be used for not just contract dispute, but also as actionable intelligence to make decisions, such as the brewer ordering a new batch because this batch is potentially ruined, or perhaps generating an additional notification for that receiving party to perform additional quality control measures. Again, this was just a very quick tour of Oracle Intelligent Track and Trace. Thank you for your time.
Oracle Supply Chain Cloud enables you to drive insight and collaboration that you need with smarter ways to detect problems and opportunities within and outside the enterprise, to decide the best course of action, and to then execute end-to-end business processes that can address them. Oracle's Supply Chain Cloud is not some far-off vision. It's here today, ready for you to begin your journey beyond resilience and pivoting your operations to growth. So the time is now. Pivot forward, define your future, partner with Oracle. My name is John Chorley, and thank you for joining me today.
Earlier in the program, we saw a short video showing how the complexities in the telecommunications industry aren't always seen, but yet we know they exist. Transforming to a digital organization can lead to more efficiencies and insight through automation. And when you're a large organization, the complexities of getting everyone on one single platform is a big undertaking. So what is the reward? Our next guest speaker will address this question. Arun Kumar is a general manager for MTN, a large telecommunications company with over 300 million subscribers spanning Africa and the Middle East. Let's hear from Arun Kumar, general manager, as he shares with us how he handled a large-scale business transformation for supply chain management.
My name is Arun. I'm the general manager of planning and fulfillment and supply chain at MTN Group. It is the largest telecom operator in the African continent, and we operate in Middle East as well. I look after supply chain management and all the digital transformation efforts of MTN Group, covering 21 countries in the Middle East and Africa. We operate in Nigeria, Ghana, and Ivory Coast, Guinea-Bissau, Guinea-Conakry, Eswatini, a portion of Botswana, South Africa, both the Sudans, the Republic of Sudan, South Sudan, Yemen, and even Afghanistan. So we are the eighth largest telecom operator in the world. And primarily our services are limited to mostly building mobile networks. So towers and radio connectivity for our people could be anything from either a basic 2G connection, 3G, 4G. And of course, now we are expanding on 5G. We do a lot of wholesale, which means we work with large organizations, other telecom operators, and even people like Facebook and Amazon. It's not like dealing with the European Union, where everyone talks the same and there are standard processes in place. We have four or five big vendors, mostly from China and Europe, who supply our entire infrastructure to build our network. We own and operate our own network for sure, but the materials that are needed to build that comes from all of these operators. Visibility was the thing that drove us about even thinking about digitizing our supply chain. It's a great thing to have, especially because global supply chains are completely hammered by the pandemic. Trade lanes are closed. Vessels are not moving anymore. After the pandemic hit us, we saw a massive spike in our traffic, which was obvious because people are sitting at home doing the same kind of calls that we are having via Zoom right now. We saw upwards anywhere from 30% to 70% increase in traffic capacity that we had catered for. So we had two objectives from a supply chain perspective. One, ensure that your network is resilient enough for a 12-month period that you have enough spares, enough equipments, enough network capacity, and the manpower needed to make sure that your network quality does not dip. That's the first one. The second one was to make sure that you build enough resilience into the network that when you have a peak in traffic of 50 to 70%, that people's calls don't get dropped and people do not get a lower or a worse internet experience. So we built a supply chain control tower, built visibility through our global trading, global trade management platform of Oracle. We connected into four of the biggest supply chains manufacturing systems. Now, that way, we are not dependent on just periodic interactions. Instead, we get the data fed to us. So we get to know for a $30 million that we have, at what stage each of the commodities are, which country is going to get it first, when are they going to get it, is there going to be a delay? And we are able to track that. We are looking at freight costs. That partnership of planning together with our vendors, which used to be a very traditional approach, it kind of got on steroids. And now we are literally having meetings with them almost on a day. During the pandemic, it was on a daily basis. We slowly shifted to a weekly, but on a supply chain perspective, we are doing every alternate day with those guys, just to understand, guys, what are the things we need to do? We are even tracking things like individual country challenges. So in Cameroon, for example, I've had a massive problem because ships don't call often because of longer clearing times. Now, therefore, we need to find alternate ways how we can move it in. Now, there are going to be certain countries like Uganda, which are landlocked. Therefore, I cannot fly everything in. It's going to cost a lot of money. So I have to get them out at Mombasa port and then drive from Mombasa into Kampala. So these kind of insights, when we start working with the partners a lot more tightly and closely, I think the analytics platform along with the global trade management stuff is really what helped us out right now. Supply chain resilience and the management of supply chain risk became so relevant to our executives and our CEOs that now we have a place in the executive committee to say, listen, this is what we are picking up. This is what we are seeing. This is how important it is. So we are literally sitting here as supply chain, telling each of our operations, which of them are financially healthy, where the cash conversion cycles are okay. Are they paying too early, paying too late? Are the inventories consumed at the right number of inventory turns as per the commodity type? And are they getting their receivables on time? Now we are challenging that with all our implementations in place. So next year, sometime when we talk about it, hopefully, we'll have a much better story for you.
We're covering a lot of territory and industries in this program. Our next guest is from Italy. Alcar is an industrial and commercial group founded in Switzerland in 1962 that manufactures steel and alloy wheels. No doubt they've seen many changes with technology and manufacturing over the years. Recently, Alcar moved from an on-prem to a state-of-the-art, fully integrated cloud solution, and they've experienced a lot of change. IoT is one of the most recent endeavors. Here to share their experience with this move and how it has affected their supply chain operations, please welcome our next guest, Mr. Stefano Mariani, IT manager of Alcar.
I'm Stefano Mariani. I'm the IT manager of Alcar Vuote. Alcar Vuote is a Swiss company that is part of a European-wide group with the business in alloy and steel wheels for car. Alcar Vuote is the company of the group that has the mission to design, develop, manufacture, and distribute steel wheel for cars. We have the overall complete set of processes for a complete company. Our wheels are purchased to mount winter tires. This determines a very high level of seasonality of our sales. So it's very, very important to manage the planning processes. Second important point, we are a Swiss-based company. Due to the high level of labor cost and the quality expectation from our customer, the continuous improvement of the efficiency, effectiveness, and flexibility of our processes is a mission. We have a tight correlation with the new car markets because when a new car is on the market, the first and the second year are a key for success because we have to distribute and provide all the warehouses. So who has the capability to be first in development of the wheels probably win the race in the distribution against the other competitors. We started to implement Oracle IoT in our company in January 2019. The process control and the real-time reaction in case of deviation from standards is a must to increase the availability of our machines. We are studying also the ML AI features on board of IoT to anticipate the issues and reduce the cost of not quality. And after the completion of the pilot stage, we extended the solution to all our machines. Technology provided by Oracle was, let me say, user-friendly, and we were able to implement in a very, very short time. In a very short time, we were also able to integrate the IoT production monitoring with the other Oracle Cloud products that we are running, like Manufacturing Cloud, like Maintenance Cloud. There are a lot of type of devices with a lot of type of software on board, but the capability to call and transmit and receive data in real time is the key success factor that in on-premise is not possible, but on the cloud is possible. Then all the information are collected in only directly in real time without complicated conversion processes directly in the cloud database. And in real time, these are ready to be distributed in a reporting system organized according with the different level of the organization in more or less synthetic reports. And on board of the autonomous database, there are all the keys, all the API to connect all the other Oracle solutions. Today, we have spoken of IoT production monitoring, but logically, also the supply chain solutions are very important to distribute in real time the changing in the supply chain information. And this provides to our management the information to react and correct forecasting and business scenario in real time. That's the key point. We survive and we win in the market because we are capable to react with a very high level of flexibility when something is changing. So the capability to capture and compute and react in real time is the key factor for the success of the future business.
Hi, I'm Mike Lim, Director of Digital Supply Chain for Oracle ASEAN and North Asia. Like other markets, we all share similar challenges in supply chains, and one of these is how do we unify multiple systems into a single platform, including our partners, so we have better visibility and can collaborate more effectively. Let's hear from Pravaka Prasam, Chief Information Officer in Mumbai, as he shares with us the Innovation in Motion project at global logistics company, Transworld.
My name is Prabhakar Prasam, CIO Transfer Group. I'm responsible for digital transformation across the group companies. Our company is into end-to-end logistics services. Our presence is in 11 countries and we have partners across the world. Innovation Motion is started in 2018. This project leverages technology-enabled solutions, customer connect, e-platforms, real-time information, improved business processes, and digital interfaces. We have 22-plus entities coming together and working on a new technologies. We are using Oracle products in all part of the businesses. These products have really improved our employees' productivity and improved our decision-making and the visibility. This pandemic has enforced us to evolve our operating system and be paperless and dependency to operate from office. From day one, our offices were closed, but employees were connected. And this was possible because of adoption of cloud. The decision, the bold decision what we took in 2018, where we said that entire organization operationally or financially should be on cloud after the pandemics. Digital technologies in this industry will be front-ending the businesses. And that's the way to operate. People are connecting, people are building e-commerce sites, they are getting into blockchain platforms, they are building analytics, and they are moving on clouds. So all these technologies which were actually only discussed before this pandemic, and now people have realized the importance of these technologies. IoT is playing a key role where we are able to give visibility to the customers and our operating team, where they are able to track our goods and transportation services, and they are able to connect and tell customers. We are digitally connecting through our ERP. We are giving them updates on even on WhatsApp of their status of their shipments. Customers are today very happy because they are getting updated. Our drivers are using mobile apps today where the shipments are sent to them through the mobile app. They are accepting the shipments. They are being tracked using the IoT platform, and all their settlements are done based on this. When we started this journey with Oracle and the partners, we realized we have one of the most complex thing to be done on Oracle Cloud. So what today we have done is our all companies are on a financial platform. Our majority of the companies are on operating platform with multiple product configured on cloud. This is one of the biggest challenges in last 2 years. Think digital is the new term what we introduce. Everything what we talk today is the digital cloud and technologies like blockchain, technologies like IoT. We know these are going to be a future. We just don't have a logistics services. We are a company with the logistics and technology, and we are going to offer you technology solutions which will help to improve your business and save your costs. That's our offering to our customers, and that is changing our life as well as customers' life.
This wraps up our program. We hope you found this informational and insightful by hearing from such a diverse set of companies from all around the world. It is exciting to hear all the inspirational stories as we face the demands and challenges in the fast-changing supply chain and manufacturing industry. So, what's next? I hope we sparked some ideas. Have you been thinking about your next steps? Or maybe you're inspired to learn more? We've just the thing for you. Our Insight and Collaboration campaign website is now live with hundreds of useful resources ranging from top-tier overviews and thought leadership to compelling videos and demonstrations, or even more technical and detailed demos and solution briefs. Wherever you are in the process, we're here to inform, facilitate, and connect you with the right resources. Anything you want to add, Glenn?
Thanks, Marcel. And of course, thank you, Michael, for your comments. And a big thanks to our guest speakers from Deloitte, Oracle, Bissell, Alcar, MTM, and of course, Transworld. It's been a real pleasure to host this virtual program with you. And though we miss meeting with our customers and partners in a face-to-face format, I think these virtual summits are a great way for us to have you hear firsthand stories from passionate supply chain leaders from across the globe. So hopefully this program can serve as your starting point as you learn to explore and move on your journey to supply chain. So again, thanks everyone for attending the virtual Oracle Supply Chain Summit. And again, don't forget to check out all the valuable information on our collaboration campaign website. Thanks for joining.